Facebook. Yep. This is going to be a fun show. I've got some old friends, new friends, and a lot of funny people. So, Carol, how about that theme song?
We've how got about it? Let's do
theme
it.
Theme song by the late and great GT. And everybody can start their watch parties while we listen to this song. Trying to start my watch party still. I got one watch party. I guess that's all I'm gonna get tonight. I try to go on multiple pages. It's like a race. That song needs to be longer. But anyway, I got one watch party. If you're my friend on Facebook, you will see it. If you're my friend on my page, you won't see it because I couldn't get my second one going. But anyway, welcome to Dive Bar Comedy. This is gonna be a good show. I'm excited about our lineup. We've got a lot of funny people. All right, I'm Wild Joe. I said hi to Carol Newell on tech. Carol, you look like you're in a new bar tonight. What's going on?
I've used this bar before. It's, okay. I like it because it's blue.
I like it. I like the moon.
Kind of electric.
Nice, nice. All right. And then we've got our host with the most, Mista See.
That's right. That's right. What it do, what it do,
man. Where's your shirt?
Oh, I got these tank tops that I bought because, you know what I mean? It's hot right now in L.A., but right now I'm in a crib chilling, so I'm going to go with a little half shirt to have some flags so I can give them a little six-pack, you know.
Wow.
A little bit of that.
All right. Like that. Don't. That's my shirt. When I was a little kid, I used to do that.
I bet you did.
Trying to look sexy.
You did. Okay, cuties from Netflix. Calm down.
All right, let's get into our comics. I'm just going to go in the order I see them. Roz Browne.
Hey.
Whee. Hello. Oh, I'm excited to have you on. We were trying to start a podcast last year, right? And I don't even think we got one episode recorded. We just had a meeting about it.
Right.
Oh, nice.
Right. It happened.
But you were hilarious on stage. I think I saw you at that Irish shop.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
The green Irish place.
That was a lot of fun. There's a little stage in the back of an Irish gift shop.
Right.
And it was different, but it was a cute find. Very cute place.
Yeah. Did you
think
you can try to hook that up?
Yeah.
They might be doing socially distant shows, but you'd only be able to fit like five people in there.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's all it was there anyway.
Yeah. Yeah. It's indoors. So
Yeah.
What have you been doing, Roz? What's been keeping you busy during this pandemic time?
Hey, I've been in the house with my dog. He's around here somewhere. And working and just trying to do a lot of things online, you know, do like classes online, webinars. I'm so tired of Zoom. Everything looks like a Zoom after a while. I have no clothes under from the waist down. I just wear like workout outfits, nothing. I don't go anywhere.
All right. Well, yeah. That's good. You're staying safe.
Yeah. It's so unlike me, but yeah, I am.
Yeah. I saw your dog. Your dog was very cute. Have you been taking your dog out on walks or to the dog park or anything?
I have to. Yeah, he goes to the dog park, but he doesn't really play with other dogs. He just sniffs around.
All right.
He'll sniff enough, then he'll go. He's ready to go home. That's all he does.
That's probably very exciting for him, though, getting to sniff where the other dogs were.
Yeah.
Dogs love sniffing.
They do. Yeah.
So, Roz, for people that don't know you, how did you get started doing comedy? Where'd you come from, and how'd you get into the comedy scene?
I'm from Boston, and I came out here to go to school, USC, and I became a CPA, actually. I got a job as a CPA, and then I had a job I didn't like, and then in between jobs, I took an acting class, and then that acting teacher told me that I should do something, whatever I was scared to do, that's what I should do, and the only thing I could think of was stand-up comedy.
So
I took a stand-up comedy class way back in the days, and been doing it ever since.
So it hooked you. It didn't scare you. It must have become addictive.
I was shaking like a leaf, but I liked it. I was on stage shaking. You know, when your friends and your family come, because they're friends and your family, and they'll laugh at your jokes because they're your friends and your family. And it was fun.
So were you always the funny one in your friend and family group, or is it something that you just explored on stage?
Yeah, I'm a middle child, so... yeah, that says a lot right there. Middle out of seven.
Uh-huh.
My mom was the funny one in the family. Everybody else was more funny than me. I was quiet because my mom told me, "You have nothing nice to say. Don't say nothing at all." So I really didn't say that much at all.
Oh wow! Wow!
I love it.
That's great. You found an outlet. Then you found a way to find your voice.
Right. On the stage, I can say what I want.
Awesome. Well, we can't wait to hear your set tonight. I'm excited to hear your thoughts on what's been going on. So welcome to the show. All right. Cyn Delgado, once known, formerly known as Cynthia Delgado.
Yes, just dropping some letters. Why not? Let's get rid of it.
It's sexier this way.
Easier at the DMV. Yeah. I mean, you know, the whole... I'm actually for the kiosk thing at the DMV and make it easier. I mean, they're always mean to me anyway, So, you know, I've got to renew my tag. So I'm excited to renew it by kiosk. I've just got to find one.
Wow. That was actually, I used to dance. Cynthia was my stage name when I was working the pole. So, Cynthia.
Yeah, look at her. Yeah, nobody could dance like that.
It's also my aunt's name, so that was kind of weird, but it ended up like there can only be one name per person. So, I wanted Cindy, they didn't have it, so I went with Cynthia, and it was kind of, you know. Either way, I like them both. I like Cindy, I like Cynthia, but I love Cyn. That's more you, I would say.
Thank you. Yeah, you know, and it's interesting because like when people call me Cynthia, I feel like I have to, you know, put myself together and pay attention a little bit more. And, you know, like either I'm going to do your taxes, I'm going to do real estate, or I'm going to be like your attorney. You know, either way, like we're going to kick ass and we're going to win. Like that's Cynthia, you know, you want Cynthia on your team. Cyn. You know, Sin's got the bar going, you know, let's see, what do you want? We've got, you know, we've got this, we've got a little something else, you know, hi, how you doing? Come on in, you know.
So, yeah.
Yeah, there's a little
Cyn
bit
is sort of dark, and then Cindy is like kind of airheaded, you know.
Well, hey.
I like them both, Cindy, and Cynthia is more seductive.
more. You've got Cindy Lauper, you've got Cindy Crawford, you know.
Okay.
There's some, hey, you know, come on.
Okay, I guess I go straight to Cindy Brady.
Cindy Brady. Well, Cindy Brady was cute, fun. Who does not like Cindy? Does anybody here not like Cindy Brady? Is anybody not a Cindy Brady fan?
No, I think Cindy was cool. What was the Three's Company chick named Cindy too?
Oh yeah,
Chrissy.
There's another Cindy.
Oh, Chrissy.
No, close her enough. Cousin Cindy. Her cousin was the
name.
It's
all the same.
Anyway,
so what's been keeping you busy these last months?
I just told you.
Drinking. Come on.
We got this. We got this one here. Let's see. We got this one.
Oh, where's my drink?
Filled up here.
I lost mine.
Let's see. Hold on. I got another one. Oh, I got to make sure I stay keep myself hydrated. So I have my water.
Oh, I lost my drink.
So that's one thing is definitely drinking. So when you asked me to come back again to the, you know, dive bar comedy, I was like, oh, perfect. Late night, I can have a drink or two and, you know, chat with some funny people. I loved it earlier when everybody was just going back and forth. I was, you know, going to send a message to Carol and say, are we recording this? Because this is just comedy. Everybody's just having conversations and it's like, we're here, still hearing each other. It's just, it was really cool. I don't know. That was my experience.
Oh, and it was you. You were the one that was commenting. I think the week before you came on, you watched the show and you were commenting a lot in the live feed, which was a lot of fun. We had these hot twins, guys, and you were asking them about their workout routine and kind of getting a little flirtatious, I think. But yeah, it was fun having you in the chat. I love it when people chat in the live feed. It's a lot of fun.
You gotta encourage that. You know, you definitely gotta encourage that because people sometimes they don't know what to say. And I say, you know what, just say hello and, you know, or where you're from. And because it's, I mean, this is really cool that it's worldwide, you know. You
can see
it's worldwide. I know that maybe a lot of people are on the West Coast, but I think.
Have you seen any of the people in the world?
Somewhere. Where are you from, Big John?
San Francisco.
So not everybody's here in Southern California. No, so.
Well, he's Northern California. Just Northern.
Yeah, I am the immigration problem.
Once in a while, I get somebody writing from the East Coast that asks to be on, but for the most part, I'm just booking people I know from LA. So pretty much everybody is an LA comic, except for a few off the internet that, find me or I find them somehow. So, but Cynthia, you're from our live shows. You've done a lot of dive bar comedy shows in real life. And maybe one day when the bars are back open, we'll see you in real life again.
Oh yeah, they'll be open soon. They have to open up soon. I mean, it's,
they were closing at
the bars.
Liquid Zoo. And I saw the sign, the GT's Comedy Jam banner is still on the side at the corner of Sepulveda and somewhere in the valley. I can't remember the other, I don't remember. I just said it, Liquid Zoo.
Oh, Liquid Zoo, yeah.
Yeah, it's right there. There's a Chevron, there's a McDonald's, and it's still there. That banner is still up, but they haven't been able to be open in many months now. So
March 15th, that was the last show I did in an actual bar.
I feel sorry for the owners because I don't know what they're supposed to do, you know. How are they getting by at this time? But anyway, it's rough for people that work in bars or own bars right now.
Once they get
I'm happy you're there in your virtual bar, and I'm excited to hear what you have to say tonight, and welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
Let's see. We've got Big British Jon.
I am.
So you are up in Northern California, Jon?
I am obviously not originally.
I heard that you were in a fire situation recently. What happened?
It was half a mile away from the house. The complex fire that you've seen and on the TV, that was literally at the end of my, I live in the hills. I don't have neighbors. I have dogs.
Wow.
And
so what happened? Did they put it out or is it still roaring or what's going on?
Let's not jinx it. It's still going on, but it's relatively under control at this end, but
okay.
Not somewhere else. So, you know, the biggest fire in California in 10 years. You know,
you were not asked to evacuate or anything, or you're staying in your house, or you had to go somewhere?
We had evacuation notices, and we had our RV all packed up ready to go at a moment's notice. The dog's crate was in the back of the minivan. We were ready to go, but I was staying here. I'm on the local water board, and so we were making sure that the water system was ready for the fire brigades to tap into if they needed to. So,
oh wow,
real life's a real pain in the. It's just not funny.
Well, you're the local water board. That's very responsible of you. I don't think I've met anybody on a local water board. How long have you lived in this town?
I've been here, 8 years and change. So
how long have you been on the local water board? I mean, that's really getting involved in your community.
7 years and change. No, I live in the hills. I don't, I live in a semi-agricultural part of San Jose up in the hills. And so you're either involved in it or you don't get water. It's kind of, myself and two other people, there's six of us under the age of 60. So basically if we don't volunteer, we ain't getting nothing.
Utopian.
Wow.
It's how it is. So.
Wow. So Big British John, apparently you must be from maybe London. Are you from London?
No, lass. If I use my real accent, I sound like this. I'm from north of England. I'm from Yorkshire.
Okay. And then did you start comedy over there or you came here and started comedy? How'd you get started?
Both. I didn't take the traditional route. I was an after dinner speaker for many years, a raconteur. And I would host sportsmen's dinners. So their final year of professional play, they would get a year dedicated to them. This was their pension pot, basically. And I developed a bit of a reputation for roasting, and that was great fun. And then I came here and I gave it all up because, you know, that's not something we do here.
There's a lot of roasting.
Right, but I left my network. I left that world behind. I left the ability to do it, the dinners and the people.
So when you use the word I've never heard before, would you say a raconteur?
A raconteur.
What is that?
Oh, the raconteur.
He runs a racket, like a mobster.
No, it's about a professional storyteller, a raconteur. You bring them in and you keep them there. Peter Ustinov is probably one of the finest raconteurs, and Dudley Moore and Peter Cook. These old traditional comedians, and they would just talk and bring you into this story for hours, and that's what a raconteur.
Storytellers. I think we call them storytellers here.
Yeah.
They were probably called minstrels back in the olden days, right?
We're not allowed to use the word minstrels these days.
That's how everything is. It's gone a bad word now. Jeez.
Yeah, you can't. This is the other one. How do you spell it? N-I-G-R-E-N. Ginger. You can't say ginger. There's another word which uses the same letters but a very different order.
You're gonna get them on me.
I love that one. You can use the letters, but not the words. I'm British. We started all this shit. As soon as you guys work that one out, we're in trouble.
Well, I love the British vocabulary. I went to London, and even the bartenders were using big words. Everybody was using much bigger words than they use over here. So I appreciate that.
That is our gift. We made it. You broke it. Thank you.
The vernacular.
We're doing the business English. It's like 10,000 words. So we pick the 10,000 most important words and forget about all the long words.
The guy with the longest surname here is using words like vernacular. Hold on. He's going to show you something special in a minute. That's the...
All right. I'm super excited to have you on, Jon. And I love your accent. I've been watching The Crown. I've been binging The Crown lately. Oh. So I'm I'm always into British stuff, but I'm really... big into British stuff
right
now.
Those were the days when we had an empire and no complaints about it.
Oh,
good times.
Oh, well, I'm happy to have you on, and thanks for finding us. Let's see. You mentioned a long surname, Meyrowitz, Joshua Meyrowitz. What's up?
Hey, Joe, how's it going?
Good to see you. I haven't seen you since the Comedy Store a long time ago. You were there almost every day, every week. Definitely Monday nights, and I don't know have you been back to the Comedy Store in their new reduced form?
No, in actuality, in May, I broke my ankle.
Oh, how?
So funny thing. So I normally drink nothing but water. And what they don't tell you about that is, as healthy as only drinking water is, it's unhealthy because it washes out all the electrolytes from your system. And I thought electrolytes were like something added to drinks like high fructose corn syrup. So like, I drank nothing but water. And then one day I just passed out on my feet on top of myself and I fractured my ankle on all sides.
Oh no.
Oh wow.
So how'd you find out about your electrolyte imbalance? Was that your doctor told you about that?
Yeah, they said you need electrolytes in your system. So now I drink a Gatorade a day.
All right. Gatorade a day keeps the
bones
away.
And this was about a good month or and a half before they decided to start doing roast battles at Comedy Store again. And I'm still on the mend even now. So I can't very well be jumping around doing my thing. Yeah. Off. I've been doing Zoom open mics completely naked. Well, I don't show anything, but I'm not afraid to have my shirt off. That's my whole point. But unfortunately, thanks to a broken ankle, I can't be attending. No matter what safety precautions they're taking, I'm still wary because, you know, we're still in the pandemic and I don't want to fuck around.
Yeah, no, I could tell that your ankle is still healing. It doesn't look 100% yet.
I've been in physical therapy the last like month or so. So I'm still like working on getting like back to 100%. They say I'm going to be able to walk and run and jog. It's going to be a bit.
Wow. Oh, well,
that sucks.
At least it was kind of good timing because everybody's just staying home doing nothing anyway. So it's a good time to recuperate.
Yeah. It certainly helped. But you know what? I'm happy. It gave me a lot of thinking time and it also gave me, maybe I needed like a little time of peace. Granted, it fucked with my stand-up, but I think this has been a good time in terms of solitude.
Yeah. Yeah. Granted, I think for a lot of people feel that way. People are, you know, being forced to spend time with themselves and spend time with their families and get more introspective and work on their homes. People are cleaning out their closets and that kind of thing too.
For me, it still kind of sucks because I'm a crazy person and I drive myself crazy. So that solitude also turns into extreme anxiety.
Uh-oh. Well, I mentioned this a couple of weeks ago. We've had a few comics cancel last minute or even a week prior because they had anxiety issues and they said I'm not going to be able to do the show because my anxiety is so bad. But that must be a common thing.
I'm happy when I go on stage or perform in general. It's the one place where my anxiety basically goes away, but like other than that, I'm a maniac. So
yeah, I see. And then they call you back at the Comedy Store, they call you Autistic Thunder. You're on the spectrum. And I was mentioning earlier that I've been watching the Love on the Spectrum since I'm watching a lot of TV more than I ever did before now. And
because you're taking care of a little one and everything. I gotcha.
And you know, yeah. And you're sitting around, it's either cartoons or, you know, after 8 p.m. I say, okay, no more cartoons. Cause they'll just watch until 1 a.m. Like they don't go to sleep like normal babies. They just stay awake partying as late as possible.
Hey, listen, I'm my mother's child and the baby of the family, so my mom's constantly communicating with me. Are you okay? I want to make sure you're okay.
Oh, that's nice.
Same here. Yes.
On the spectrum.
Oh, that means she cares about you. Aw.
I mean, she's sweet. Possibly autistic too, so in a sense, that's also love on the spectrum.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I noticed that. They showed a lot of the parents with their kids, and you know, some of the parents were they were like real cool. Like, I don't know, like their kid was like more
just for their kids,
just different, you know, like it was just different. Like they might have like a real loose, cool parent. And then the kid is kind of like stiff and rigid and, you know, not even kids, because these are kids that are like 20 years old already, and they're right. starting to date, you know. But it was interesting to see the family dynamics too.
Yeah, this is pretty much the same with my family. My parents are very like liberal with things, very cool headed in a sense. I mean, they're also anxious Jews, and I'm their child, so I'm an autistic Jew. But yeah, my parents, especially with comedy, they're just happy I found something for myself. So it would be the same if I found a relationship. They just want to see me happy.
Yeah, that's good. I don't like people that pressure their kid into finding a relationship, because you really can't control who you meet or when you fall in love.
Jewish parents, my mother would always say, "I hope you would find a nice Jewish girl." Like, I'm like, aww. let me just find someone.
Oh, well, I'm happy to see your face, and
thank you.
Can't wait to hear your stand-up.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Yeah, welcome to the show. Woo! Let's see. Oh, we're down to our very last new comic, Rosalee Mayeux. Am I saying that right?
Well, it's
Mayo? Like mayonnaise? No.
Very close to mayonnaise. It's Mayeux.
Mayeux. Oh, it sounds French.
Like French.
Wait.
Nice. So, how did you hear about the show? Were you on a Facebook checking us? How did you hear about us?
I don't know. I just know you reached out and went, "Oh, I know Johanna," and that was it.
Okay.
Yeah, cool. But I've been seeing your cool ads. Best flyer.
I've been working on. Yeah. I saw this.
Yeah,
other
it is
guy
really good. I like it.
Flyers. And I asked him,
the
what
best flyer
app is, are you using?
Yeah, no, it's the best flyer out there.
Thanks.
Yep. And
oh,
I
thanks.
Can't read
yeah,
it.
I've been working on that. And I have so many ideas of more things I want to do. But it's just a matter of finding the time and the technical know-how to get it done.
Yeah.
But yeah, I got Spark is the app that makes the moving graphics for the ads. So I started doing that. And then... I just read recently that it's super easy actually to get on Amazon Prime, and all you have to do is put your video on YouTube and then do the closed captioning, which YouTube will kind of do for you automatically in a way. And then once you have your video closed captioned, you could put it up on Amazon Prime, and like anybody could do it. So
what is
I'm
closed
like,
captioning
oh.
even mean? Worse.
People think Words. It's so hard to get on Amazon Prime, which I would think too. But I guess it's like somebody posted it in one of these comedy boards that it's like super duper easy.
It was Tuesday.
All you have to do is have closed captioning.
Yeah, Tuesday Thomas. Shout out to Tuesday. She said she's been helping people do this for years and it's super easy. And I went, what?
Yeah, because I'm like, oh,
but
I want to go back
what is closed
and put all these episodes on Amazon Prime. So we could be like a series. We'll
yes.
start with a theme song.
Absolutely.
And put our shows up. We have like a show every week. I'm like, hey,
yeah,
we're going to Amazon Prime. The
and
big
you know,
weeks.
You, I mean, because it's so great because you put your shows everywhere and they can see past shows. Most of the problems I'm running into are people that are in Louisiana or New York and they can't watch a 6 p.m. show. It's 9 for them. They've
right.
got kids. By the time I'm on, it's 10 o'clock at night. They're over it. And you... I don't know how you do it, but you're really good at technology because you can go to divebar.com and comedy, and you can watch like yesterday's episode.
I'll tell you my secrets.
It's Carol,
so
your secret
Facebook, secret. You could get any video off of Facebook and download it as a video and save it to your computer, and then you can upload it wherever you want. So if you go, there's this site, it's probably an illegal site, who knows, it's called sbdown.net. You put the address of the Facebook video you want to download in it, and it just downloads it to your phone, and then you can upload it everywhere else. So it's
well,
easy.
You've done great. You've done a great job.
Thank you.
I thought
so we're all getting an Amazon Prime credit.
Oh yeah, we're gonna be on Amazon Prime within weeks. I just have to do it. It's a matter of doing.
Carol teaches me, I will too.
Yeah, Carol, our tech guru, needs to get
I just
want to
say
sorry
to all those comics that have an Amazon Prime special credit. Yeah,
yeah,
we got
I was
one now
impressed
as well.
With all those people that had an Amazon Prime special, and now I heard that anybody could get on. So it's like selling a book on Amazon, that you could just sell your old book off your shelf.
The conversations in the garden at the comedy store are going to be very different from now on. It's going
to let's keep this a secret.
It's all about closed captioning.
Us and our viewers that are going to learn this when they watch it on Amazon Prime in a few weeks. So, all right, Rosalee, where'd you come from? How'd you get into comedy?
It was totally by accident. I had never thought of doing stand-up before. I started off as a model in New York as a youngster. Ooh. And I transitioned into acting for 20 years, right? And I got really sick. And so because cancer is so funny, my roommate at the time said, so how are you enjoying your improv? And I said, not thrilled. And he said, oh, you should do stand-up. I'm going to start a class, but I don't know who to invite. I said, well, I'll go and support you for a month. And unbeknownst to me, after that month, he put my name up at a workout place. And that's how it all started. And once they gave me a microphone, that was it. I was like, oh, I have some shit to say. Hang on. I've got issues. And it's been fun ever since.
Oh, well, that's great. No, it's a similar story for a lot of people. It's like a way that we all found our voice. Like, and people talk about stage fright. I used to sing in a band and I would be so nervous singing because if you have a cold or allergies or something and you might hit the wrong note and you want to be taken seriously and, you know, whatever. And doing stand-up is so different because you can just goof off and be stupid and say whatever. And you get the instant feedback from people. You know, I don't get nervous at all doing stand-up, but I used to get super nervous singing for some reason. So I don't know. And the funny thing is, when I was singing, the worst part was having to talk in between songs. I was like, oh God, what do I say in between songs? And then now I'm just sitting there talking all the time and I love it. So anyway, well, welcome to the show. And I think you're the last person to interview, so I guess, Mr. C, it is time to start the show.
Yeah.
Let's get it going.
Yeah. Nice. Good, I'm excited. A bunch of good comedians, some classics, some new comedians. All right, so let's get ready. All right, so you guys ready for the Dive Bar Comedy Show? Can I get a yeah?
Yeah.
That's right. So get the clap. It's the Dive Bar Comedy Show. I'm Mr. C, the Enforcer, a.k.a. Poppy Caller, the bad boy. Skip Bags representing to the day is long, and I'm very excited to get into these comedians coming to the stage. We got four sweetnesses and two gentle bulls, and we're going to break it down real sweet. And we're going to start off with a family favorite classic, a sweetheart of sorts, as they call her back home. She is our technical guru. She is the woman of women. She is a mother. She is probably a daughter. Most women are. She is also a lady in her free time. She may pay your bills if you're young and handsome. It's what she does, it's not my fault. I did not raise the woman. I'm just saying. And we're not. So you got to get ready because she's new and she's very well. And you got to get it up and give me a clap. But Carol, the love of everyone's life, Newell.
I'm just trying to be the love of somebody's life. I got a haircut, you guys. I don't know if you noticed, but I did get a haircut. Great. I got a new girl, didn't really speak good English. So I said, I just wanted to take a little bit off the top and on the sides. And evidently what she heard was lesbian. I was thinking about the time my sister called me from the hospital, you guys. She called me about, I don't know, like 2 years ago from the hospital. She got ran over by a car, you guys. I was like, wow, what happened? And she's like, oh, it was a hit and run. And I was like, well, did they catch the guy? And she's like, no, but I'm okay. I'm going to be okay. And I was like, well, that's good. And then, you know, she recovered. And then like 6 months later, one day I get a phone call from her and she's like, I broke up with my boyfriend, Danny. And I was like, oh, wow. Is that good, bad? I don't know. And she's like, oh, it's good, because it was really bad. And I was like, oh, okay, well, that's good then. And she's like, oh, and remember that time I got ran over by a car? And I was like, yeah. She's like, it was Danny. I was like, wow, okay. And I was like, well, good thing you got rid of him. So time goes on. Like 3 months later, I get a phone call one day, and she's like, are you going to come to my wedding? And I was like, wedding? What? Who are you getting married to? And she's like, Danny, duh. What? And she thinks there's a black cloud following her around. I was like, okay, sure, I'll be there. Not gonna happen. And then like a month ago, she called me one day and she was like, somebody broke into my apartment and they stole my wallet and my phone. And I was like, oh no, that's terrible. I feel really horrible for the thieves, because imagine their surprise when they try to steal your identity. Not gonna be fun for them. I was like, but look on the bright side, your credit score will definitely go up. So it's a thin line between love and she was talking to me a couple weeks ago. She told me she was gonna fly halfway across the United States to meet some guy, and I was like, okay, well, you better go before October, because in October you're gonna need the real ID. She's like, oh, I already have the real ID. And I was like, oh, how nice for you, I can't get one. And she's like, why not? I said, because mom decided when I was in third grade to go to the school and change my name and didn't do any paperwork or any, you know, legal process to do that. She just went down and said, oh, her name's this now. And I was like, so now I can't get the real ID because I can't prove my name change. Thanks, mom. And she's like, asked my mom, why did you do that? My mom's like, I didn't do that, Carol changed her name. I was like, mom, really? I went down in third grade and changed my name? No. I was like, besides, if I was going to change my name, I would have changed to something cool like Cher or Madonna. Mom, she's crazy. I was a white sheep in a black sheep family, you guys. That doesn't sound like it would be bad, right? But imagine like you're a teenager and the only thing you could do to rebel against your family is not drink, not do drugs, and be responsible. So that sucked for me as a teenager. Although there was a silver lining, I did get to learn how to drive at 15, you guys, because my grandmother needed a designated driver. 2 DUIs in 1 year, not good. So I got to do that. That was fun. I was married for 20 years, you guys. 20 years is a long time. 20 years is a life sentence in some states, and it certainly was one for me. Not delightful. I feel like marriage should be more like military service, where you have to re-enlist every 4 or 5 years. It's just done. And a lot less like capital punishment. So not a good time. I have a kid. I didn't plan to have a kid, but I acquired one of my sister's kids. So, not bad though. We got her at 5. She was a rescue. She had papers, she had shots. We just, said, okay, we'll keep her. And now she's a teenager. So don't, you got that to look forward to, Joanna. That's not going to be fun for you. Teenagers. She's a that age, where she can't like put dishes away or laundry or any of that stuff. She can't close cupboards, take her shopping. She comes in the door and leaves the door wide open, and I'm like, could you close the door? Were you born in a barn? And she's like, do you think that Mary used to say that to Jesus? I was like, no, Jesus talked back and then they strung him up and hung him from a cross, so you might want to consider that. Don't have those teenagers. They're not a lot of fun. Hopefully we'll get past it though. Hopefully. I'm gonna leave you with this. I am an essential worker, you guys. I'm working in the office and I haven't had to quarantine this whole time, you guys. It's great. I get to go to work, I get to get out of the house, no traffic. It's the best thing ever. Except for 1 week I did have to quarantine because I went out of town. And it was the longest week of my life, you guys. I was like,
I can't wait to go back to work. Like one day I took two naps and I don't know what happened to the rest of that day. It's gone. So yeah, I'm an essential worker and I'm just, you know, making sure we have food on the shelves. So that's what I've been doing with my quarantine, and I'm going to give it back to you, Mr. C. Thanks for having me, guys.
Right, that's right. Good job, Carol Newell. Ooh, I liked it. And she touched on life. She touched on everything because she is a versatile lady. She touched on the teenage years, like our host tonight, future teenagers, man, teenagers, right? So I was a teenager. My sister was a couple years older than me. And as a kid, the two differences in teenagers was what she said about girls. But for boys, we're just really stupid, but we eat like fucking elephants. Fucking elephants. I mean, we're just eating. Just like, oh, do something. Just like, give me some food first. That's boys. And then the other thing is, now girls, right around 12 to 13 years old, I don't know if the ovums are getting a flipping or something, but every morning, my sister and my mother would argue for 30 minutes before she left the house. I'm talking about death battle. And me and my father would stand at the bedroom door and look at each other like 20, 30 minutes of death battle every morning for like two years. So anybody that has a teenager and you're a woman, get ready for the 12 to 15 year spurt of the death battle, because it's two ovums in the same house. Somebody's going to end up dead. I'm telling you, so they get ready for that one. So beat them early. That's the whole point.
You can't hit them anymore. They know the number for CPS.
Oh man, that's why you gotta beat them.
Or they can beat you up. You gotta beat them with the phone.
You gotta beat them with the phone. So my friend, when we moved from Philadelphia, his dad tried to call the cops on him. He just hit him in the head with a hammer. So that's how you handle that. Yeah, it was really cool. So, once again, another round of applause for Carol Newell. So, next up, we got another gentleman coming to the stage. Actually, I like this dude. He reminds me of when I was a little kid. I liked the WWF, and there was this guy called Big John Studd. Bad motherfucker with long, beautiful blonde hair. He looked like a Greek fucking god. And this man is most likely his uncle. So you get ready for it, because it's coming to you fresh and clean. He's cool. He sounds like he goes to a place called the Apothecary. So you better get ready and get your hands together. Give me a clap, 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 clap. And all kind of loves. Big John Brittain!
Oh, you are far, far, far too kind. You really are. I like the idea of the apothecary. That was the first place I went to in Vegas for legal weed. That changed my life. Thanks for having me. The clue's in the name. Big British Jon, originally from... Liz says hi. Doesn't know what you're doing, but you're welcome back anytime. pay your bills and make real tea. There's no ice in it. this is the accent you could have had. But no, you wanted to sound like John Wayne if he was gay enough to order avocado toast. I'm spending a lot of time at home. I actually just had just got my hair cut about an hour ago. Apparently they think I'm a lesbian as well. I think my wife wishes I was one. No, I think we need to stop calling it the COVID-19. I think realistically, we're looking at kind of a 25, maybe 26 pounds at this point. It's not getting better. I would say, you know, I'm not going to the gym, but that's not exactly something I did beforehand either. Jim's a nice guy, but we don't need to see that much of each other. I'll tell you how bad the weight's getting. My wife has actually changed my sleep number to avoid a crush injury on her side of the bed. Everyone else eating through this. I'm figuring that's the case. I'm eating a lot of brie by the wheel. I think that might be where the real problem is. pardon me. It's been food's been important in our house. It's helped us define English better. My wife is an American. I have an anchor baby just in case it doesn't work out. And we finally sorted out the difference between an English scone and an American biscuit. Oh. On paper, they look very similar. There is a key difference, though. That would be lard. There is a lot more lard in the American biscuit. And I'm fine. I mean, I've just got over opiates, and now I'm onto those. And I could have handled that, but then I found out about sausage gravy, and turns out everything good comes from the Carolinas. That's what I'm learning so far. Now, thankfully I don't have any allergies to these things. My daughter, however, I have a little daughter. London, that's not where she was conceived, if that was your question. otherwise she'd be called drunk the morning after Christmas in the guest bedroom, and you just can't fit that on the paperwork, you know. We're in California, so you know, Febreze was an option when it came to names. she has a terrible allergic reaction, from what I can tell, to underwear. She's 4 years old, and if she has her way, she's running around naked the whole time. In fact, I'm doing this live from her bedroom. Not that she sleeps here. If she can help it, that's, you know, mummy's bed is the best place for that. I agree. It's been a while. And so if you are a man and you're watching this and I'm in my daughter's bedroom, understand this is the first and only time you'll get in here and get away alive. Just want you to know. I'm not protective. I'm armed. These are the things you do when you have a kid. But no, I wish, you know, she's got this allergic reaction. She will not wear underwear. I just wish my wife had the same allergy. That would be that would be awesome. I can't complain. My wife is a former U.S. Olympic swimmer. She competed in Atlanta. If you want to do the math, that means she's a lot younger than me. Also, if you think the accent is an attractive thing, sure. Probably the only thing that was attractive, but god damn it, if you've got it, use it. The name Big John is the only thing big about me. Now the I'm blessed. She was a former US Olympic swimmer. She paid off her college loans, 2 degrees and a PhD in psychology. She obviously makes very intelligent but poor decision making. I mean, seriously. And she paid off her college loans as a swimsuit model. I mean, that's phenomenal.
Go ahead.
Real benefit of this one, guys, is a lifetime of full body shaving, and I don't have to be a pedophile about it. It's all about faster times, and for me, they are. No, I'm. It's a real issue. Body hair. I'm curious, and I'll come back to it. It makes sense. Why did you want to be great again? As a nation, I'm from a great country. We've had it in the name for 2,000 years. You know somebody who didn't think it was that great? Jimi Hendrix. He died in London. He choked to death on a British woman. That's how hairy they are. I was raised on a farm. I know how to shave a sheep. I'm one of only three guys in my class that know both the name and species of what he lost his virginity to. Everyone else, it's a mystery. No, I am curious. I come back to this, you know, make America great again. Personally, and that's why I have an American daughter. She's called London, and in 32 years, she will be eligible to run for president. Her campaign slogan will be "Make America Great Britain Again." And at this point, does it seem that bad of an idea? No, I'm going to be honest with you. You know, we talk about the politics and how divided this nation is. This isn't the country I wanted a green card for. It's not. I wanted to get married to Daisy Duke, and it turns out Boss Hogg is running the country. This is the crazy stuff to observe. Look, let me help you all out. Before I was in comedy, I was a professional hacker, and this is a bit of a public service announcement. So you should know that Google incognito mode means that Google is not watching you, but I am. I've been going through your browser history. I've been watching some of those ASMR videos. Okay, they help me relax. I noticed one or two of you have been making them. Frankly, that's some disturbing stuff. I'm not going to name names now because I don't have enough time. But if your online, if your online forum name is Donkey Tamer, we need to have a conversation. I have just two questions for you. Why a male donkey? And don't you feel bad about donating to PETA as well? These are just things I don't understand about you. Now, I can't wait until my daughter starts dating. I'm going to use those same professional skills when he turns up at the door. Hello, Daryl. I assume he's going to be white and called Daryl. I mean, let's be honest. If she brings anything with a suntan in, there's going to be questions, seriously. It's going to be, you know, in this part of San Jose. I said, you're going to marry Jesus. Apparently my wife said, no, she's going to date Juan. I'm like, okay, I'm going to have to get used to this. But no, just understand people. Google's not watching you. The world is full of perverts. I might be one of you. This has been my time. Thank you so much for having me. It's great to be on your show.
Yeah, that's right. That's right, Big British Jon.
You're very, very kind.
The married bulldog.
We tried.
I like it. And I'm with you, Big Brit John, on this thing. His daughter is a fan of mine because I'm the same way. When I used to come home from Catholic school back in the day, first thing I did, I was allergic to pants. But I would never take off the shirt and the tie, and my dad would tease me. He's like, boy, I'm going to tell you one thing. You'll be a good homeless person because you always keep the shirt and tie on no matter how much you mess around. So today, your daughter is going to be a great homeless person. So be proud of that, Big British Jon.
You're very kind.
Right, that's right. I'm not homeless. I got a place. So feel comfortable. Well,
I've been living in an RV for the past week. So seriously, I'm like all the other poor Californians.
Preparing for homeless. Hey, Lori, maybe she'll just be great at Zoom meetings. She'll be good at Zoom meetings. Naked from the waist down. And business on top. That's what you've been working towards your whole life, Mr. C.
Absolutely. These are the dreams.
This is true. Even though a couple weeks ago I did show my tidy whities in the middle of a performance. So got a little carried away. Once again, another round of applause for Big Rich Jon, everybody.
Thank you very much. You're very, very kind.
All right, now we got the next comedian coming to the stage. We're going to go back to back with a couple of ladies. We got a classic veteran of the dive bar comedy scene coming to the stage right now. This is one of our soul sisters and whatnot. She got the cool name, so crown and cool and tasty, like it's flavor coming to your mouth, like a moist brown E similar to her name. So you better get ready and get right. Woo! Are y'all feeling right? Can I get up? Yeah.
Yeah.
Right, so get ready to get a brownie stuffed in your motherfucking mouth and give it a clack, 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 clack for Roz, the soul Browne.
Thank you. That was the best intro I've ever received. I like that. Thank you for that. I like it. I like it a lot. During the interview, I had mentioned how I got into stand-up and the reason why I got into stand-up. I kind of have to confess. I got into stand-up because I like being out. That was pretty much it. I just wanted to get out the house. You know, that was it, really. I was married at the time. I'm like, how can I get out this house? I'm like, oh, yeah, I'll go do stand-up. And I always like being out at night. Anybody else? This is really bothering me being in this house during this time because I'm a night person. I'm an outdoor person. I like to be out. I like to be out at night. For me, it was either being a comedian or a hoe. At night. I know I should have said that. And you guys were kind of like walking around that John's Brit's daughter. Y'all know you all want to say she might be a hoe too. Walking around with no underwear on, right? I'm not putting that out there, but you need to check if she go out at night a lot. She go out to do stand-up. You need to go follow her. Go follow her ass, because, you know, if there's no stand-up clubs around, she might look at other opportunities.
She's going to have a drone for a chaperone.
What?
She's going to have a drone for a chaperone, trust me.
Yeah, you got to do that, because you know what? It's And I'm not putting hoes down. Don't get me wrong. I have nothing wrong against hoes. You know, like I said, I had hoe aspirations. I just didn't want to do that. Back in the day, a pimp even liked me. A pimp said, you know, you could do this. I'm like, no, I can't. And besides, he wasn't even a good pimp. He was on the bus. I'm like, you should have a car. That's what pimps drive, Cadillacs. Not the bus with coupons. How are you gonna check on your hoes? Stopping at each bus stop, getting off and on? You got my money? Back on the bus, you got my money? Doesn't work like that. I'm just sorry. Carol, you talk about your sister, crazy people in your family. I understand, because I got crazy people in my family. I just can't talk about them right now because they might be listening. But you know, crazy people, a lot of times they're okay. And the crazy people, what gets me is they always have somebody. They always have a mate. They always have a boyfriend or girlfriend. They're never like single. Mm. I guess crazy people, they have good sex, right? They give good sex because they have no inhibitions. It's like, they could be crazy. You can't take them out during the day, but at night you can get in that bed with them, right?
Yeah.
Oh, it's just too much. Yeah, and this all COVID thing is like, I feel sorry for these parents out here. I don't have any kids. Yeah, you can give up for me. No kids. I got no kids. I feel sorry for them because, you know, they got to homeschool them now. And they talk about, you got to teach them things at home. I'm like, my kids will be straight up stupid. I'm like, I'm not teaching them shit. They'll be looking at TV. I said, what you learn today? Or they learn about how General Hospital, how somebody got married to somebody else on General Hospital. That's what they're going to learn. I said, my kids would be dumb. They'd be like, why are your kids so dumb? I'd be like, because they closed the school. Don't blame me. You blame the city. You blame LAUSD. I didn't tell them to shut down. Making my kids stupid. No, I was married too. I was married for 17 years, if you want to call it marriage. Yeah, my marriage is kind of different though. Though the reason I'm not with the, I don't even call him the ex, I call him the why. Why the hell I married him in the first place. The reason I'm not with the why is because the dog, I got a dog. I don't have any kids, but I got a dog named Tip. And the dog was running around with a DVD in his mouth at the time. I said, Tippy, what you got? And I took the DVD out of his mouth and it said, My Special Picks. And my husband's writing. I'm thinking it's some porn. Let me see what he likes looking at. Big booties, I'm sure. And I got it and put it on the computer and there was photos of him with another woman. I know, I couldn't believe it either. I'm looking at all the photos. And then I looked at my dog, Tip, and he said, woof, 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 I got some more. The dog went and got three more DVDs.
Ooh.
So, of course, I confronted the why. And he said, who are you going to believe, me or the dog? Like, well, the dog got the evidence. So now the dog got a new job. He's a PIP, a private investigating pooch. And people ask me, did the dog really do that? And when I say yes, then they say, can I borrow the dog? So the dog's been busy. The dog's been busy. I've been busy too during this time. I got a job, like I said, the comedy don't pay all my bills. I am an accounting supervisor. I have a staff of 4 people and they're all white.
Oh.
Yeah, that makes me really happy. The first thing I did when I got my job, I said, from now on, my name is not Roz. From now on, my name is Massa. Just call me Massa. I think that's my time. I see a 1 minute here. There's a whole long bit to that joke, so I'm not going to go into that. I'll do that up the next time.
Hell yeah.
Great. My name is Roz Browne. Thank you.
Yeah, that's right. Another round of applause for Massa Roz Browne. Yes, ma'am. I was going to tell you, Massa Browne is the best Massa I ever done had in my life. She's understanding. She's disciplined. And she only whips us 3 times a day. My last master did it 6. But he paid as well. So we let it slide. That's right. Another round of applause for Roz. I like that shit, Roz Browne. I'm talking about good life. So we're gonna keep it going back to back because I want to make sure I don't drag on because I do drink a lot. So we're gonna go right back to back with the next comedian, and the next one coming up to the stage, she bringing that whole switch to the flavor because we had the Soul Sister, we have a man from Britain, so he's English, so he's kind of like white and black at the same time from Hannibal conquering them. So he's a little bit of both and whatnot. And then we had the sister and whatnot, which is like Hannibal's cousin and some of the Indian's cousins. And they came over here. And next up, we got some of my Latino and Indian and Caucasian. Actually, man, a little bit of everything. It's the kind of person that's coming to the stage that makes you say things like, ma, tu mira muy bonita y delicioso. Say shit like that when you meet. So you better get ready. Take you to the world that makes you feel flavorful, feel love. Her name is the kind of thing that makes you want to do bad, even though it represents good. So get it ready, get it hype, and give me a clap for the CYN. Not the lady called Cynthia, but Miss Sing, the Gaggle.
Yes, thank you. I'll definitely drink to that. So welcome to Dive Bar Comedy. Yeah, it's just, you know. I mean, yeah, so I'm definitely drinking more, I think, like many of us, and also smoking more of that wacky tobacco, you know. What do you have time to do? That, you know, like I said, you know, mainly that, so why not? Also, another thing that I've been doing besides drinking and smoking is collecting karaoke songs. I don't know if... I definitely got to share with you, but I have a 4-month-old puppy. Oh. And she's a chug, and Ruby Peanut. She's asleep right now because it's past her bedtime. But we go out to Petco. Petco's a great place, you guys. And, you know, as far as right now, you know, I know we're all limited on where we can go, but Petco is a place you can go, and you don't need a pet. You can walk in there. I see people with no pets all the time. You know, it's quite a questionable, but I don't question it. You know, they can actually just, like I said, no one's going to question if you don't buy anything. Just go in, listen to the music, you know, but it's kind of nice when you're listening to something like this. And, you know, they have the best karaoke song. So you guys can add this to your karaoke list when the bar starts opening. Yeah, you know, I'm just saying this is a good one, you know. Let's see. There was another one that was playing there too. And it's hard because, like, I'm just, you know, there to, you know, get a toy for my dog, you know, but then you got this one too. If you like Kenya, you know, and I get distracted and I'm like, what am I here for? Because don't forget, remember, I had a little bit to drink, you know, and, you know, probably smoking at some point. And I'm like, okay, what? Oh, we got a Petco. You know, this is a good song. And then, you know, and then one last one, you guys, but this is a fun one. This is what gets everything going. I mean, it's just a good beat, you know. Anyhow, yeah, just collecting karaoke songs. I, you know, woo. Give me a hole. Make sure you have your bus fare. If you have people, do the buses still run? Or, I know, right? This is a lot of fun. I know. This is a good song. But yeah, definitely. Kids, like I said, collecting my karaoke songs. So yeah, Ruby's cute, my dog, as far as Ruby Peanut. Another thing that I do like, you guys, is that they're cleaning everything, like, you know, the shopping carts, you know, some of the gas stations are even clean, you know, so I'm kind of liking this, you know, wash your hands, everybody's washing their hands, you know, people are even giving you hand sanitizer, offering you towels, you know, so I don't know, there's some positive to the side. You know, I just wish they would have just thrown in with the fine print, wash your ass, you know, that would have just done so much with everything, you know, everybody been washing their hands and washing their asses, or wait, vice versa, wash their ass first and then wash their hands. I don't know, just saying, if they just would have thrown that in, because
they would say, you know, this would have slowed things down. You got to make sure. Remember Dr. Fauci? I don't know. Just saying, if things could have, you know, been pretty cool. Dating's always interesting. Like I said, my girlfriend and I do have this cute little puppy together, Ruby Peanut, a chug. And we've been dating for a little bit over a year, but we know when you're dating someone, it's always interesting because you're getting to know them, you're asking questions and you know, and seeing what's there. But sometimes red flags come up, you know, and you tend to just maybe, you know, look away or just pretend that you maybe didn't hear them. But, you know, with my girlfriend, you know, so a couple red flags came up and one of them was she's banned from Uber. So, yeah, I don't know how you can. Well, I mean, I've heard stories of how people get banned from Uber, but, you know, and then wait, on top of that, she's banned from she's banned from Lyft, too. I found out she's banned from both platforms. So if we go anywhere, it's, you know, on my app. So quite interesting. Yeah. And if you look at her, she's sweet, you know, she's very sweet, you know, and you wouldn't even think about, you know, but anyway, so but yeah, you know, ignore these, you know, red flags. Why not? You know, another one, too, is you guys, she's in a cult. You know, I'm not, you know, a part of it, but I know you guys have heard of it. You know, it's everywhere. A lot of people are talking about it. I mean, it's nothing new. And it's called veganism. No, I mean, I'm telling you, everything, you know, you say something, oh, Whole Foods will have it. You know, it's like, that's their church, Whole Foods, you know? So just, I don't know. It's interesting, you know, but yeah, I'm not converted, you know, yet. We'll see what happens. Yeah, no, I love smoking weed. And it's interesting because when I go places and I'm, you know, I'm like, wow, you know, in my head, I'm like, I smell weed. And I have to realize and remind myself, it's you. There's no one else here that smells like weed. It's you. You smell like weed, you know. So that's always fun. You know, it's quite interesting because things have changed. You know, like going into the shops, I'll kind of show you guys. They kind of give you these cards, you know. You know, my dealer never gave me anything like that, like free delivery, you know, punch cards, you know, I was just happy to get anything, you know, from, yeah, like I said, it's changed. You can get anything. This is what I'll leave you with. One last thing is the names that they actually call these stuff. You know, you'll hear something like Saturn OG. You know, I just wish they would name the weed to the side effects, you know, like Paranoid Penny. OG, like, did you guys hear that? No, I heard something. You guys, that's my time. Let's keep this show going. Woo! Woo!
Delgado, yeah.
Which means thin, by the way, Mr. C.
That's right. I like it. It was a good show. It's a good show. Good stuff. That's right. I'm going to keep it moving back to back like Cook Crack in the Hood and whatnot. You know what I'm saying? We're going to keep it spicy. Once again, all of these different kind of flavors coming to the stage. We got the British Boy and whatnot. Then we got the Soul Sister and whatnot. Then we got El Latina de Grande and whatnot. And next up, we got one of my J Bros with the J Froze. And I love it anywhere we like. Matter of fact, recently, stupid guy called Nick Cannon said some old dumbass shit because he doesn't realize the origination of where all we're from. So we're going to learn something today. So all monotheistic religions, right? Monotheistic religions actually do come from Judaism, which is the first original religion. So Christians who don't like my J-Bros with J-Froze and Muslims who don't like my J-Bros with J-Froze, I hate to break it to you, it comes from Judaism. Christians, it is a jewel on the cross. Anyway, so remember that. We're all teammates in the game, and that's what it's all about. So get ready, because we're all family at the end of the day. Only 0.01% of your genetic structure makes a difference in how you look, and the rest is all the same. So get ready and show some love. And can I get a clap, 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 clap for my J-Bro with J-Fro? Yeshua, a.k.a. Yeshua Meyrowitz.
Hey, Yehuda Asha. That's my Hebrew name. Yeah. Hey, but give it up for Mr. C, everyone. Woo! mentioned some pro wrestling shit earlier. Big John Studd. I'm going to totally hijack and go into, I'm a giant nerd, so I love pro wrestling to this day. I can tell you this. Yes, it is absolutely fake. And at the same time, I've never been harder in my entire life. Look at the body slams. They're awesome. Okay. Hi, I'm Joshua Meyerowitz. I have Asperger's, which is a high functioning form of autism. So I gotta say, feel free to laugh. Don't you get weird on me. Don't you get weird on me. I'll be weird for you. This shit is ridiculous. It's like being retarded, except I'm smart. God. Did I go too far? No. Always a line stepper. I'm a habitual one, and I don't mean ill. I as an autistic person, I lack filter and tact. I've at least accent in well-meaningness, if it means anything, have called 3 women in my life fat. Like, they ask me, hey, why don't you want to date me? And I try to avoid, but I'm not an asshole. I'm just so very autistic. But yeah, I'm what I am. I'm basically happy. Stand-up's the best thing that ever happened to me, helping me out mentally, sometimes physically. You know, it's the first time I've ever had a life. It's the first time I've ever had friends. It took me till 25 years of my life before I had friends, a place to exist outside my immediate family. Now I have all kinds of people in my life. It's a melting pot of different races, sexes, and creeds. You know, I have Asian friends and Asian friends who are gay. I have Latin friends and Latin friends who are gay. I have Black friends and Black friends who are on the down low. It's a different culture. I do not judge. But yeah, and my parents have never seen me so happy either. They're very loving. They're so very Jewish. I was born with autism, but everything else is their fault. That's how bad. my mom, ever since I got into comedy, she's like, you're the best. You're going to be the next Adam Sandler. You're going to be Saturday Night Live. I just know it. Look at you. You're adorable. You have a cookie face. You're my Pookie with the Mookie. You know, your brother and sister moved out, but you still live with us. The doctor always said, I get to keep one. Yeah, and then my dad's always saying shit like this. He's always like, Joshua, you're a comedian. You're more like a vampire. You sleep all day, and then you go out at night and suck. Daddy. Yeah. It's like I was born with 2 disabilities, autism and Judaism. I actually recently broke my ankle, if someone wasn't listening earlier, and my parents, my mother especially, was like, well, just, I live in an apartment currently, but my mom was like, you can come live with us for the next 2 months until you get better. We'll take care of you. I'm like, no, I escaped you for a good reason. She fattens me up. She keeps the shelves stocked. When I lived with them, until I was almost 30 years old, until I was 30 years old, period. My mom would keep sandwiches she'd like, listen, I got you a sandwich. It's there for you just in case. And I would be like, well, I just ate lunch, but I'm still going to eat that sandwich. it was terrible. I needed to go. I'm still fat now, but at least I can say it's not my parents' fault. I am a mushy mogwai man. I jiggle, okay? like my torso looks like a sad ghost.
Sad ghost, do. Yeah.
Very sad. Very sad ghost.
Yeah. Very sad. Doesn't want to say boo. Well, Mr. C's happy.
I can't believe this is going on Amazon Prime.
I'm a nudist. I don't give a fuck. Wait, did you guys, did it mute during when I was?
Yes.
God damn it. I told like two good bits and it fucked up.
Sorry.
I'll live. We'll all live. We'll get through this whole thing. I don't know. Listen, the wall's closing on me all the time, but at least I've gotten experienced things before COVID. Like I lost my virginity. And I got to tell you guys, I needed that. That was so good. Like, do you know about this thing? Sex is ridiculous. Like, I lost it to a prostitute, and I gotta say, we gotta legalize prostitution. It's helpful. It helps people. It gets people by. And those women deserve all our love and support and money and insurance and not, you know, be served to us in a container from Yugoslavia or some. We just gotta treat women right all around. Black Lives Matter, trans rights, and don't be a misogynist prick. Like, I sit on the toilet when I pee, and everyone's like, oh, you a woman? I'm like, I guess I am. I guess I my small peenie means I'm a big old woman. And you know what? There's nothing wrong with that. I'm a woman. I'm a man who's not LGBTQ+, but I'm a woman. I'm a very womanly. I'm my mother's child.
Mama's boy. Hell yeah.
Yeah. Just one last thing. I'll keep it quick. Sex is great. I gotta tell you guys, after I lost my virginity, it felt like I lost some of my autism. Yeah. Take notes, Jenny McCarthy. I just hurt my own charity. Fuck for the cure. I'm dropping my story very much. Thank you. Bye.
Yeah, that's right. Woo! Yeah, I ran.
Right.
I liked him. And yeah, shout out to everybody with autism and Asperger's and stuff, man. Cause real talk, yo, they just don't like the rest of you motherfuckers. We don't like all that high and by and what you
doing. Scare us.
I mean, cause they want to talk for no reason and shit. They're not that, like, let's just be functional. Where are you going? What are we doing? But all that, what are you doing? I haven't talked to you in a minute. Are you not dead? Then stop fucking calling me. I just need to know you're not dead. So I think I have Asperger's. That's crazy. So I love you, man. I'm on your team with this shit, man. Team Asperger's up in this joint, man.
Hey, yeah. Thunder.
That's right. Another round of applause, guys, for Mr. Meyeritz. Woo! All right, we got our closer coming to the stage. Good situation, about to tear it up too. Also, let's see. We got our final comedian coming to say, did you guys enjoy the rest of our comedians so far? Yeah. That's right. So we got one last comedian coming up to the stage. And I like this comedian. Got a great last name that reminds me of my own heritage. I looked up my last name, which is Anthony. I found out it is a French last name. So I feel like me and her are probably related in a distant way. It might have been her great-great-grandfather that helped my great-great-grandfather in some certain kind of way in the 1800s. It was not. And it's just like my girl, once again, look at the flavor we got going on up in this joint. We got my man from Britain up here. We got Carol Newell, which represents the entirety of America. Pick something. Just pick something in America. Carol, it's in there. It's in there. And whatnot. Then you got the soul sister with that Roz. Then you got my girl Sin, sweet Latina flavor up in there. Then you got my man up here with the J Bro, with the J Fro, curly like Bob Ross and the gang up in there doing his goddamn thing and whatnot. And last now, we got somebody that holy vous de français. It's like s'il vous plaît, croissant, French fry. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. Beautiful. So let's get ready for some good love. Everybody in the mix of the world. Give me a clap, 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 for Rosalee Mayeux.
Hey guys. Thank you guys so much. I loved all the comedy before. This is awesome. I'll tell a quick story before I get started about Joshua. So I was pretty new to comedy, maybe what, 2 years in, and I was on Kill Tony, you know, rite of passage in California is you're at the comedy store and there's the biggest podcast in America, I guess, Kill Tony show. And I get called up as, you know, one of the newbies so they can make fun of me. And Joshua knew who I was. It was amazing. Joshua knew who I was. He called it out and remembered my character's name in The Lawnmower Man.
She was a good actress.
A famous movie with Pierce Brosnan, and I played the love interest. And Joshua remembered my character's names and called out Carla Parker. And I went, what the? Who would know that? Joshua. But he made that night so special. I love you.
You're
love
welcome.
You
I'm so alone.
It was so wonderful. It made me feel so good in a room of 300 people going like, what? It was really sweet. It was really sweet. And Sid was talking about her dog. Oh, I think everybody here loves their pets and has pets. So January 15th, my roommate and I had been fostering elderly dogs who needed a place and there weren't any that needed any help, but they frequently, if they get a puppy, they have to adopt them out really quick because it's not good for them to be in a pound. It's too noisy and it frightens them too much. So I looked online at the next dog up after three of them weren't available of the elderly dogs, and there was this puppy. And so I called them and I said, do you guys need me to foster this puppy? And they said, sure, if you get here. I mean, they go pretty quick, but if you get here in 30 minutes, I'm sure he'll still be here. So I drove to West LA to the No Kill Foundation. And they said this dog came from the Ghetto Rescue Foundation, which is gang members in Anaheim and police in Anaheim do this good deed of taking dogs off the street. And I said, oh, that's great. And I said, does he have a name yet? And they said, yes, his name is Portillo. And I said, oh, I'm going to be a white lady with a solid black dog, y'all. And his name is Hispanic. So I've covered all bases. If he has like an Asian name, I would be completely covered. Here he is. Can you see him? Is this going to show? Sleeping on the bed. Yeah, there he is. There he is. He turned one August 1st. So I don't know what it is. They put them in your arms and like an idiot, you just fall in love instantly and are willing to let them eat the console of your car on the way home. So I'm at home and I'm walking in by the apartment. There are some painters outside doing the building. And they said, oh lady, that's a really cute dog. And I said, thank you. I think I'm gonna keep him, rescue fail. And they said, oh, what's his name? And I said, his name is Portillo. I looked it up online on Google and it means little door. And they said, what? I said, Portillo. And they said, lady, you know what that means? It's a little door, back door hooker. Little is the back door on a hooker on the boy hooker on Santa Monica Boulevard. So once again, Joshua, you're right. We should legalize prostitution and make my dog an honest boy. Sometimes I think they name him names just to get the white ladies. Just make fun of the white. Let's name him bitch, but call him puta and she won't know the difference. So, I mean, this dog is he's solid black. When I walk into a room at night, I can't find him. it's that he's that black. I took him to Petco the other day, and a lady walks in and goes, "Oh, he's so cute! What a cute puppy!" No, he's average. He's just a black dog. But she went on and on because it was a puppy. And she goes, "Is it a boy or a girl?" And I said, "Oh, it's a little boy." And she said, "Really?" And she got down on her hands and knees and looked under his belly and said, "He has a really small dick."
Wow.
Number one, why does that lady want my dog to be slinging a big dick? And number two, that's prejudice. That, because he's black, she expects him to have, all right, that's a really bad joke. I've been eating ice cream the entire time of COVID. I have enjoyed myself immensely. And your mind wanders. You're alone in the house, or you have 17 people around you that you can't get rid of and make them leave because they pay rent, but whatever. And I was looking through my notes at all the lies that people are in relationships here. Or is everybody in a relationship?
Hell no.
Nope. Yes.
Nope.
No.
Just a daughter with no underwear, that kind of thing. Let's see. So first I was married and I didn't have kids, and then I got married and I had kids, and then I fucked up my joke. So I'm single. But everybody here on dating apps, if you're single, are everybody does it but me, I think. But I think I finally found the one dating app that might work for me, because I'm a broke comic and I need to think about finances. There's an app that says the guy pays you for the date. It's not like one of those hooker services or anything. It's literally the guy pays for the date and comes over, but they don't leave. They have to spend 24 hours with you. They have to spend the entire night. You can cook dinner together. You can go swimming in the moonlight, down to the beach, whatever you want to do. But you have to spend an entire 24 hours. So what if he's short or she's heavy or whatever it is that other people think, oh gosh, I don't want that. You know, that wouldn't be perfect enough for me. Whatever. You spend 24 hours with somebody, you can really develop a good friendship and see if it really works. And I got to tell you guys, I love it. It's called Airbnb. And I'm booked through November. So that's it for me, guys. I love you all so much. Thank you for having me. This has been great.
All right.
Yeah, that's my
Rosalee.
Wow.
Great job, really. All right. So that was all of my comedians, and I love the diversity we had tonight. I'm gonna close it out, because we had a whole lot of America here tonight. I'm gonna just do a little rap about my life, which has the whole American universal world experience. Then Miss Joe is gonna take us home and close the deal out. So let me center myself, and I'm gonna finish it up. And I'm gonna also run through the comedians' names, and then Miss Joe will close out. So I'm gonna do the rap, do the names, Miss Joe will close the deal.
Miss to see you the best.
Yeah. I love you, girl. That's right. I love you and your great, 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 great uncle. He helped make me great. So I surfaced to the world as a third of a man and second of a woman. Economy is booming. Check to check, no more looming. Let's move into a bigger space. Too many living in an apartment place. So begins the case of that product me, Mr. C. Born and raised in the hood, Mount Airy. Mental looking kind of scary. The neighbors say, how dare he talk about the hood like it's ghetto. I take him to the bar and make the asses drink stiletto, because I tell him about the background. Went from minimal to Mac pounds, and everybody run away is getting jacked now. Yeah, I see the crack now. Yo, it's killing me. You feeling me? The reefer steady healing me. I flash back to the fifth year when I started school with no fear. G-Town Montessori year, I went there. My only memory is eating Sloppy Joe there with my fro hair. Last step is elementary me. R.I.P. to my wildin' brother Tyree. St. Therese is where they dropped me. From K to 8, religious rate, the familized state. What's up to my brother Nate? Don't worry, brother Carla, always wake up late. And then I wake up late, and let's move to the high school fool. Shorty's looking good, got me on a jewel. Short and skinny, kind of cool, but quiet though. The loving pilot, yo. Staying with you like the Hyatt, bro. I must attest. ENS was the best, the third best made the stress test, so they made me take a rest. Only lasted for about a year. Next step, Lake and Nas here. So I miss my brother K Digger, P Money D RZA, and myself the great. So I had to fill my mental plate because I'm coming late out the gate. I graduate the Hampton, had love like Fred Dunn, and yo, I always was Ant Man. And you love the way I kick it because I stamped them. One love to everybody with universal thoughts. And let's run through everybody's name and all the comedians. Can I get a clap, 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 clap? We had a great comedian. Start off, Ms. Carol. Yeah.
Thanks for everybody who watched.
Let me look at everybody and so I make sure I got them all my eyes right. Okay, here we go. I don't know what y'all say right. Okay. Next step.
Thanks for all the fans.
Thanks for staying.
Thank you, guys. Phaedra, can you say dive bar comedy?
I'm not gonna be. I just gonna run by names too. And then also we had Big John, Big British Jon. He did his goddamn thing and whatnot. Also we had Roz Browne. Next up we had the Cynthia Delgado. And of course we got my J Bro, J Froze. We keep it cool and sweet. What's up to the baby in the background? How it go down? My man, yes, you are married. That's right. And of course, we had a lady close it out with the left, right. My family favorite and whatnot, because we all from that French swag. We like. We motherfucker. And you better always show some love to Rosalee Mayeux. Yeah. And also shout out to the godson right there. One day he's gonna eat up all the food and be stupid. Shout out in the background. Taking home wild, yo, Mr. C out.
Aww.
Yeah. Good job,
this was a fun show. You guys are awesome. Phaedra, can you say dive bar comedy? Dive bar comedy. Yep. So you guys can watch every week. We come out on Tuesdays and you can check the replay on diebarcomedy.com. We're on iTunes. We're on Android, the podcast station, and everywhere else, SoundCloud, YouTube, wherever you want to check out podcasts, we're there. And if you want to see us live, check us out on the Dive Bar Comedy page on Facebook at 9 p.m. Pacific on Tuesday nights. And we're coming soon to Amazon Prime. So thank you guys all for watching and hope you enjoyed the show.
Thank you.
Let's salute Commander Phaedra. Everybody salute Commander Phaedra.
Yeah.
Salute Commander Phaedra.